You want to support Roller March Unfiltered? Be sure to join our Bring the Funk fan club. Every dollar that you give to us supports our daily digital show. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. Support the Roland Martin Unfiltered daily digital show by going to RolandMartinUnfiltered.com. You can make this possible. As I said, folks, South by Southwest, the major show in Austin, Texas, has been canceled as a result of the coronavirus. The travel industry could be impacted by more than $100 billion. Conferences and cruises and all kinds of events all across the world are being canceled. The stock market, my Lord, down 4,000 points, wiping out the last 2 years. So what the hell do we do? Do we freak out or do we sit tight and take advantage of the crisis? Joining us right now is Deborah Owens, America's Wealth Coach. Deborah, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
All right, so 4,000 points gone. Last 2 years, Donald Trump is freaking the hell out because he wanted to run on the economy. He first told us, this coronavirus is no big deal. Y'all just go to work. Now he couldn't go to the CDC in Atlanta because somebody there had the coronavirus. So this thing is real, and actually it is spreading in the United States.
It's spreading, but what I say, Roland, is let's not panic. The truth is that
when folks can die from something, panic gonna happen.
Well, panic will happen, but the truth is that we've had all kinds of things happen in this country, and we've had the market be volatile. At the end of the day, what people need to understand is that the market was pretty much due for a correction. And so while all of you, everybody I talk to, oh, yes, I'm an aggressive investor, well, are you? Because this is what you should anticipate. If you have, let's say, 70% of your money in stocks, you should be prepared to see that investment go down by 60% in 1 year. Historically, that's what happens. However, I said, and even with a balanced portfolio, where you only have 50% in stocks or 50% in bonds, you should be ready to see your investment value go down by, in some cases, 30% in 1 year. The issue becomes that I just said go down. I said decline. You haven't lost anything until you sell. And what really disheartens me sometimes in our community, because many of us are investing in our 401ks, and we are basically choosing target funds or whatever the allocation is based on our age, we have no clue about what's in our investments or how to review them. So I like to give people strategies. And those strategies right now, just like you have the 3 R's in education, you have the 4 R's in financial education.
All right, what are those 4 R's?
This is what people need to be doing. The first thing they need to do is reassess. And when I say reassess, you thought you were an aggressive investor or you thought you were okay with your money going down. Are you? Probably not. So the fact is that your money has probably appreciated and you have more in stocks than you started out with when you started, right? So let's just say you were 3 years ago. Your portfolio went up significantly, and so now you're sort of out of balance. Now you need to really look at, okay, how much should I have in stocks,
right,
and how much should I have in bonds? The second thing I want to say is review what you have. So many people are on autopilot. They don't even know what they have in their portfolio.
So if I got a mutual fund, I need to review what's in it?
Yes, you need to review what's in it.
Okay.
One of the easiest way to do that, Roland, is to go to Morningstar.com, which ranks mutual funds. And what they do is they rank mutual funds from 1 to 5 stars. It might so happen that your funds were doing well at one time, but they're not. So you want to make sure your funds are at 4 stars or
more. What's the website? Morningstar?
Morningstar.com.
All right.
The next thing you want to do is you want to research. And so you're going to research at Morningstar.com, and you're going to look at how your investments perform in up and down markets. And you're going to, because they have what's called a beta, and it'll tell you, I'm not going to get too technical, but it basically tells you about volatility. And so if this makes you uncomfortable, now's the time to look at some funds perhaps that aren't volatile. And then last but not least, the last thing that folks need to do is reassess. Okay, so I just gave you three other R's. Now you're going to look at your, or excuse me, rebalance your portfolio. Okay, so how much should you have in stocks? How much should you have in bonds? How much should you have in cash? For most people, their money's in their 401k. It's retirement money. You should still be somewhat in growth mode. Mm-hmm. And in fact, what I would encourage folks to do is now's the time perhaps to, if you do invest in individual stocks, to take a look at what are some of those companies who have fallen, okay, just based on panic. And yet, what makes the stock's price go up are their earnings, their future growth, and right. all of that. So I look at this in many cases as an opportunity for folks. You know, hey, stocks are on sale.
So, okay.
You run out to the store when things are on sale. But I do say proceed with caution and do your homework.
So I'm trying to, okay, so you said you go to Morningstar to figure out how your fund is doing.
Right.
So where, here, go to my iPad.
So you go to Morningstar.com.
Right.
Right, and so name one of your funds.
Ariel.
So which fund? So if you put Ariel.
We're in a search box.
Yep, right in the search box. It's going to come up with five letters. All mutual funds have five letters in their ticker
right,
symbol.
Right.
Okay. And so if you put that fund in, name in, it'll come up with a ticker, and it'll take you to a portfolio review page.
Right.
And right up at the top, what you're going to see is how your fund...
So this Ariel fund, I don't know which one it is. I got you when I get home. So this Ariel fund investor
rated
has two stars.
Okay, yes. Yeah.
That sucks? Is that great?
Two out of five.
That ain't halfway point.
It is what it is. But here's what they're driving, what's driving those stars, okay? What it's driving those stars are, what type of fund is it, and is that fund performing at least as well as its index? Meaning,
right.
you know, if it's a large cap fund that has the S&P 500 stocks in it, is your fund performing at least with that benchmark? It needs to overperform it, though, because if that's the case, you might as well be at an index fund. The other thing it looks at is in its category. What type, how is that fund performing versus other funds just like it? How is it ranked?
All right, so if I got a fund and sitting around at one or two stars,
you need to rebalance. Yeah, you need to.
Okay, when you say rebalance, it means move your money somewhere else.
Right. So you need to look at where are the other opportunities, where are the funds that have consistently performed
right.
and have a 4 or 5 star ranking. That's one of the first things you should do in your portfolio.
So shouldn't your financial advisor also be giving you that advice?
Absolutely. That's what you pay him for.
Or her.
Or her. But what I would say is that.
Mine is here right now.
So why you gonna put me on Front Street like that, Roland? Why
Troy Salter, you ain't send me a damn email, a phone call. You ain't done shit. Not a damn thing. Troy Salter.
Why?
T-R-O-Y-S-A-L-T-E-R.
Why does he
You
put...
have not given me any advice. Troy, when the show is over, you are going to do your damn job.
That's...
No, your job is to advise.
That's not my job.
Hey, y'all, that is your job. That is your job now.
Oh my!
Yes, y'all. She's black.
So is that why you invited me on the show?
No, we need to have this conversation. The people out there don't know. Y'all got any questions? Y'all got questions?
No, I
Santiago, you got questions
you said too.
No, I'm good. I'm
y'all
good.
Good?
I'm good.
Have y'all rebalanced?
Hell no. Yeah. I bought.
Huh?
I bought.
You
okay.
bought?
I bought. Yes.
Okay,
when?
That's good.
Wednesday.
Because like if you look,
you know, one last
because here on Morningstar, Deborah, I'm looking on here, these health stocks, one of them was up 48%, another was up 12%, oil went down 10%. They're going to cut production because of demand. But General Electric down 6.5%, Bank of America down 4%. But again, this one health stock up 12.62, one is up 43.78.
Yes, but okay, let's
what does that
talk
mean?
About that. That is short term. Volatility, right? And so that's demand. People saying, oh, where's the opportunity? Healthcare, who's going to come up with the cure or the vaccine for coronavirus? At the end of the day, what people need to do is most people are in mutual funds. If they follow those four steps that we just talked about this evening, they'll be fine in the long run.
All right. Sounds good. Right, people, we get more information, Deborah.
They can go to my website, deborahowens.com. And by the way, if they want to get a free CD on investing in volatile times that goes over these principles, they just go to deborahowens.com, Uncertain Times.
All right. Deborah, sounds good. Certainly appreciate it. Toy, you got some work to do.
All right, folks, back to our Roll Mark Unfiltered video in just one moment.
All right, so a lot of y'all are always asking me about some of the pocket squares that I wear. Now, Robert don't have one on. Nope. Now, I don't particularly like the white pocket squares. I don't like even the silk ones. And so I was reading GQ magazine a number of years ago, and I saw this guy who had this pocket square here, and it looks like a flower. This is called a shibori pocket square. This is how the Japanese manipulate the fabric to create this sort of flower effect. So I'm going to take it out and then place it in my hand so you see what it looks like. And I said, man, this is pretty cool. And so I tracked down it took me a year to find a company that did it. And so they make these about 47 different colors. And so I love them because, again, as men, we don't have many accessories to wear. So we don't have many options. And so this is really a pretty cool pocket square. And what I love about this here is you saw when it's in the pocket, you know, it gives you that flower effect like that. But if I wanted to also, unlike other, because if I flip it and turn it over, it actually gives me a different type of texture. And so therefore it gives me a different look. So there you go. So if you actually want to get one of these shibori pocket squares, we have them in 47 different colors. All you got to do is go to rolandsmartin.com/pocket squares. All right, so first of all, that graphic is way too small. So tomorrow we're going to run it right down here all across the screen. So it's rolandsmartin.com/pocket squares. All you got to do is go to my website and you can actually get this. Now, for those of you who are members of our Bring the Funk fan club, there's a discount for you to get our pocket squares. That's why you also got to be a part of our Bring the Funk fan club. And so that's what we want you to do. And so it's pretty cool. So if you want to jazz your look up, you can do that. In addition, y'all see me with some of the feather pocket squares. My sister, who's a designer, she actually makes these. They're all custom made. So when you also go to the website, you can also order one of the customized feather pocket squares right there at rolandsmartin.com/pocket squares. So please do so. And of course, that goes to support the show. And again, if you're a Bring the Funk fan club member, you get a discount. This is why you should join the fan club.
Now back to your Roland Martin Unfiltered video. You want to check out Roland Martin Unfiltered? YouTube.com/RolandSMartin. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. There's only one daily digital show out here that keeps it black and keep it real. It's Roland Martin Unfiltered. See that name right there? Roland Martin Unfiltered. Like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. That's YouTube.com/RolandSMartin. And don't forget to turn on your notifications so when we go live, you'll know it.